sete, la la lo sete. Yeah, la gloria la basande. Oh, la lo sete. Let's make melody. Yeah, it's in our hearts, la la la. Let's make melody to the Lord in our hearts. Let's make melody in our hearts to the Lord. Yeah, he's done so much for us. Yeah, he's done so much for us.
This is the victory that overcomes. faith.
Even my faith. How many can agree with me tonight? It's a victory. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb. We overcome by the word of our testimony. I'm going to say I'm free. I'm going to say I'm blessed. I'm going to say I'm delivered from the power of darkness. I'm going to say this because he comes to me, but he finds nothing in me. Oh, I'm going to say I'm strong. Ha, yeah, yeah. Let the weak say, ha, yeah, 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 yeah. Let the weak say, I'm strong. Hallelujah. I'm strong. Let's lift your hands. I'm strong in the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and I'm strong in the Lord. And in the power of his might. Hallelujah. Come on, Lord. Let's bless him. I'm strong in the Lord. And in the power of his might. Hallelujah. Oh, Shiri Shete. Glory to God. Oh, we are seated with him in heavenly places. Oh, I need that blood. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
that concerns me. Hey! Thank you, Lord! You always causes me to triumph. Always! Oh, I'm going to get bold tonight. You always! You always give me the victory.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Well, you overcome by the
thank you, Lord.
And thank the word of your testimony.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, when you said what God said.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, it's just like, ah.
Hallelujah.
Yay.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
It's just like the word coming out of God's mouth.
Thank
that's
you, Lord.
Out of your mouth.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, God, we thank you today. We give you praise.
We give you all the honor.
In Jesus' name.
We give you all the praise.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you.
Oh, I love it tonight. I'm happy tonight.
Thank
anybody
you.
Happy tonight?
Thank you, Jesus.
How many got the victory tonight?
Amen.
How many got the victory tonight?
Thank you, Lord.
How many got the victory tonight?
Thank you, Lord.
Well, Satan doesn't want you to claim the victory.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, he wants to be,
anyway.
Yeah. He wants to
claim
his chances. Yes, Lord, and over you. But God has given us power and authority over our circumstances. And we reign over our circumstances.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Oh, praise Him.
Thank you.
Oh, praise Him.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, praise Him.
Give you all the praise and honor.
Oh, he that is married, hey, let him sing. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise Him. All right. Amen.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Hey,
Lord. Thank
amen.
You, Lord.
Glory. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, amen. Is there anybody in here extremely happy? If you are, I want you to stand up and say, I'm happy, really happy. Nobody can claim it?
Thank you.
I'll claim it. I'm happy! Amen. Jesus in me. Hey, something on the inside, working on the outside. Amen. We just thank God for His presence tonight. You know, we just got to get beyond the circumstances and just give God the glory. It's not easy, amen, getting into the flow where God can uplift us. Amen. But Bible says the kingdom of heaven suffered what? Violence. And the violent will what?
Take it.
Amen. Every time. Those that will diligently seek the Lord, they'll take it every time. By force. Amen. We want to do, you know, a few things tonight. And we just want to hear from anybody that want to talk. Amen. I asked somebody in particular, but anybody that got a praise report? Amen. Amen. Praise God. We just thank God for tonight, for Friday. Monday night, we had about an hour and pray, an hour and 15 time, 10 minutes. And, amen. So, Sherry, did you get happy Friday, Monday night when you prayed? Tell us what happened Monday night. Just even when you prayed, I felt something.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. So, Brother Travis, we Brother Travis and I, we turned the mothers. And Sister Sheridan prayed. Brother Al prayed. We try to get Sister Yasmin. We'll get it next time. You know, you don't have to have a reluctant prayer. You say, Jesus, 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 you're wonderful. Jesus, Jesus, thank you, you're great, wonderful. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes that does more good than a lot of these elaborate prayers. Just let go, let the Lord have His way.
Amen.
Praise God. So we just thank God for His goodness tonight. Amen. Anybody happy? Anybody merry that want to sing? You ain't that merry? Amen. I get my little singing in every time. I'll sing scripture, whatever. Amen. That will build me up. Amen. The Bible says that all right. Well, it's a good thing to be established in grace. Is that right?
Amen.
Giving God the glory. Amen. All right. Brother, why do you have anything you want to share? You've been quiet for a long time. It's about time you to get your shout out. Amen. He's been deterred and he's gone through a lot of circumstances and loss of friend and brother. Amen. Amen. Sometimes the enemy tries to pull us back. Amen. But no weapon formed against us will prosper. Amen. As long as you stay in the flow of the Spirit and the Word and rejoicing in the Lord, God will give you the desires of your heart. And He'll give you joy unspeakable. How many want that joy unspeakable?
Amen.
How many want deep joy?
Yes.
How many know how to get it?
Yes.
How do we get it? Okay, you have to pray. You don't strip yourself. Amen. And after Brother Wayne, we'll just try to get a format together for the mission that we have at the senior citizens complex at the country club. We just want some ideas as to how often y'all want to go, what you want to do, when you want to start. We need to get started this month. Amen. And we need to know, talk it over and determine exactly what's what on it. All right. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. All right, Brother Wayne, you ready?
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for being here this evening. Praise the Lord. It has been a while since I stood before you. Need so much of around those circumstances of my friends and brothers so much, you know, God rejoiced in those occasions because God answered prayer through all of that.
All right.
It just seemed like the more than anything job of mine. It takes a lot of your energy and time. Things seem like they're different, you know, when time passes. I might have heard you say that last time out of that prayer, and it seemed like it changed even more. You know, the demand and responsibility that they, you know, they place upon us. We've been in a meeting today, how they talked about they was trying to hire people and so forth, and they had turned everything over to this one agency to do the hiring for them. But this agency, they said, take 8 weeks to hire them. So I don't know, we're going to be sitting around waiting, you know, for a job, and you got other offers coming to get hired. So I just come to the conclusion they ain't really wanted to hire nobody. You know, that old, you know, old saying, you know, doing more with less. And that's a true fact that's taking place in you know, different companies. You know, they're not really out there really hiring anybody. They're just working the ones they got. Mm-hmm. And then those that they are working, you're talking about 10, 12 hours a day, and then Saturday, and if they have their own way, which some are, even Sunday, including Sundays too. So if you don't see me, just say pray for me. And because sometimes I get home. Actually, I had planned on being here Monday night, and I had, you know, I had something else I supposed to be in at 7 o'clock, but I had changed my mind about that shit. I was going to be here, and somehow or another, I guess you know, got kind of relaxed and got comfortable, and the next thing I know, I was sleeping. The pastor called me about 7:30.
Glory.
So. So I guess the body just, you know, I get one of my daughters that came back home and stayed with for a while, and she worked the third shift, and I try to, you know, be quiet. Usually I'm just busy, you know, about doing things and, you know, try to be quiet so she can get her rest and go to work and so forth. But that hadn't been working out too good for me because I get comfortable and get quiet in the house. I'm going to take a nap. But,
Jesus.
But God has been good. And I truly am thankful for what all that he's been doing. He has definitely been blessing, you know, working in our lives and my family's life. And I know one thing, she had, one of the daughter had come in through the house this evening, and she was telling me that she had bought her one of her tuition that has been totally paid off. She can't figure out why. Don't try to figure out. Don't want to know why. The other one of the things, you just say, thank the Lord, and, you know, praise Him, you know, and give Him all the praise and the glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. So He's still answering prayer.
Yes.
That's the thing we have to keep in the forefront. God is still alive no matter what's going on. No matter what it seems like we might be facing. Praise God, He's still working on our behalf. Praise God, even when we don't see it, even though you might have to go through those changes that, you know, seemingly uncomfortable, but we can press and persevere over until the end, going to play out in our favor. And that's my favorable expectation and you know, seeking God, because I don't, you know, I've been thank God for, you know, the employment that I have, but it just a stirring in my heart that, you know, that I want to go beyond that. And I know I had to place myself in a position, just like anybody, you know, for things to change. Or God could, you know, move in such a way to bless you with opportunities or employment or your own business, so He can move you beyond that where you're at. And sometimes things come about, a change take place, because sometimes He speaks to us, you know, to do something. And we get so comfortable in our environment, you know, we just settle for that, you know, because we're so accustomed to where we at. And then He'll allow, you know, circumstances to change to dry up those opportunities or dry up that position or dry up that job to get you to move, because He already spoke to you to move, but yet you won't do it because you're comfortable with it. There was one of the, I keep remembering one of the prophets that He had spoke to speak to one of the kings. And he was on his way. I think he was, I don't know if he was in the wilderness or somewhere, but he was being fed by one of the ravens. And that man, he enjoyed that. Standing right there being taken care of. God blessing him. Mm-hmm. But God already spoke to him to move and work and told him what he needed to do, but yet he decided to take a break and just enjoy the facilities of where he was at, his environment, what God was doing for him, how He was blessing him. Mm-hmm. But sooner or later, God allowed that to dry up. But get him to be moved forward to what He already spoke to him to do. And sometimes, you know, we say that we live by faith, but we just so get used to our environment, our situations, our circumstances, that we don't step out on faith and believe God, knowing God's going to work on our behalf. Praise God. Because the scripture said, a just shall live by what?
Faith.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I mean, that's a very easy and comfortable scripture to quote. But when it really comes down to living it out, that's a different thing. And how you get to be able to move really into that is through what our pastor been teaching, by praying and seeking God. And hearing Him speak to our heart and stirring us on the inside.
There you go.
And as He began to stir you in the inside, He began to give you that confidence and assurance. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That He's going to meet us at our point of need. He's not going to leave us and forsake us. Praise God. Even though you don't see the end of what's going to take place. Praise God. If He's spoken to your heart, you got to do it. Glory to God. I mean, you have to move. And that's what God has called you to do. Because it's requiring faith.
Yes.
It's not going to never be comfortable. The situation always not going to line up as you think it should line up.
Yes.
But you have to do what He's spoken in your heart. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Well, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. And, you know, some scripture that I have been really reading myself that I enjoy, Hebrews, because it kind of remind me of, you know, my covenant that I have with God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I mean, when you got a covenant, you got something.
Yeah.
I mean, we really realize that what, you know, the relation that we have with God is very unique in itself. And not only that, he binded with himself and through the blood of Jesus. And the promise that he has set forth for our life, they can be a reality in our lives. We can live in what God has made available for us. It's not just something that's just out there by on the other side, praise God. But we can live in what God has promised us in this day and time. But we got to have ears to hear his voice when he speaks to us. Praise God. But sometimes we get situations in our lives, it gets so clouded that we really can't hear him like we should. To be able to move to where we have that confidence when he speaks to them, that we know we hear his voice and we can move in that. In every situation, every circumstance. Praise God. Hallelujah. And Hebrews 10, this very familiar scripture that we have read several times, and I've read it several times, I've probably read it before you several times. Hallelujah. And this is basically says in chapter 4 to 8, I believe it was. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. It is 8 and 10. And it has two different takes on that, the way it had mentioned. Hallelujah. Let's go back to verse 9, brother. Hebrews 8 and 9 said, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the days when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Egypt, because they continued not in my covenant. And I regarded them not, said the Lord. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. Hallelujah. After those days, said the Lord, I will put my laws in their mind and write them in their hearts. And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Thank you, Lord. See, he was speaking to the children of Israel. I'm going to get my word in you. I'm going to write it, praise God, on your heart. I'm going to put my word in your mind, my law in your mind. So you have to remember the children of Israel wasn't able to keep God's commandments.
Yes.
Even as God said, I'm gonna put my laws in you, in your mind. And sometimes, most of the time, when we give mental assent to something, when we think about we're just gonna memorize scriptures and so forth, it don't stay. Yeah. We have a tendency to forget. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Glory to God.
Glory.
Thank you, Jesus. That's why David said, I would hide your word in my heart that I may not sin against you.
Yes.
Praise God. Because sometimes when our in our mind, we have a tendency not to remember when we going through. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You will forget the word of God in the middle of a situation. Yes, we will. Because sometimes we find ourselves, I'm just going to say the truth. We find ourselves a cuss. Oh yeah, saints do. Get frustrated, aggravated at our circumstances. Hallelujah. God, where are you in the midst of this? Instead of we going back with the word of God saying what his commandment has said, what he already has spoken in his word about that situation, we turn aside from that and start being more focused on our circumstances. Forgetting what God's word said. When the doctor gives you the bad report, what are you going to say? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Regarding your job situation, whatever is going on, what are you going to say? Hallelujah. Because my wife, she just had some kind of test. One of the first tests they had, I think about a couple of weeks ago, they said they saw something. And, you know, doctors always sin stuff. I mean, they're going to see something, they get you to come back the second time to make sure to see if they really saw what they saw. And, I told her, I said, well, I said, it don't matter what they saw or if they didn't saw.
That's right.
We can't be so consumed about what they say.
That's right.
If you had to look at what God says in His Word,
amen.
If we were saying, like I say, he just confessed to the just, she lived by faith.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Mm. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
It's one thing to say the scripture, yes. But when something negative starts attacking you, mm-hmm. What are you going to say then?
Right.
Do you change your mind be set about what you believe in? As you start hearing what they say, only thing I look at it like this. They give me their report. The Bible said we don't know how to pray as we ought.
Uh-huh.
And since they give me what I need to pray for, then I know how to address whatever's going on. But regardless of what they say, I'm going to believe what God's word says. This is my covenant. The Bible said, healing is the children's bread. It belongs to us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I look at it from the standpoint where Jesus paid it.
That's right.
Then I don't have to accept it.
That's right.
Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
I mean, I believe that.
Yeah.
I'm not just saying this, you know, just to be trying to make, you know, myself look good or nothing like that. My boast is in the Lord.
Yes.
I wholeheartedly believe that by His stripes, I am healed. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Even regarding my job situation, God gave me this job.
Yes.
Literally. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And if something was to happen, I know He'll provide for me. This is my assurance that I have in Him. According to the scripture that I can ask anything according to His will, He hears me. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise your Father. Hallelujah. So when we see that scripture, the just shall live by faith. Glory to God. Do you really believe? Thank you, Jesus. I believe somebody in here is being tested even now. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Whose report are you going to believe?
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Are you going to run with what they say? Or are you going to run what God's word say? Hallelujah. Like I said, thank God for the employer. Thank God for the doctor. But the employer is not my supplier. God shall supply all of my needs according to His riches and glory through Christ Jesus. I'm not looking at that. Matter of fact, I'm looking beyond that. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. It's time for God to move. I'm talking about my own testimony. To move me beyond that, what I'm looking at or what He's been using in the time past. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Bless you, Father. And in that scripture we just got through reading, what He talked about His covenant with the house of Israel, and how He was going to put His laws in their mind. Let's turn to chapter 10. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. And I mean, somehow these priests had to go through what they went through. I mean, it's just strange how God would, you know, He set that up and told them to offer the sacrifices for the sins of the people. But yet, that wasn't good enough. It didn't deal with the sin issue.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But they had to obey God, because that's the way He had set it up. Year after year, they had to offer sacrifices on the behalf of the people. Thank you, Father. Glory to God. What a task. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible said we have a more and better promise. A better covenant. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Just think we have Pastor Hill being our high priest, taking our sins, praise God, and going out and getting the animal sacrifice on our behalf. You think it's probably working now. Just dealing with that as we are. Hallelujah.
Get it all for spiritual sacrifice. Good job.
Amen. Hallelujah. Oh my God, Jesus. These poor people, I mean, the priests have to go through this every year after year. On the behalf of the people. Animal sacrifices. Our sacrifices are offered. Peace sacrifices. And on and on and on. But yet, it wasn't still good enough. Just going through almost seemed like just a ritual. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God.
Thank you,
but we have a better covenant.
Better covenant.
Just based on better promises. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Glory.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to get through this. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And you can see all through there. I'm not going to read all that. All the things that they had to go to from verse 1. Like I said, chapter 10. Praise God of Hebrews. All that sacrifice that had to take place. And I want to get to this typical one now. In verse 10. He said, by thee which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once and for all. Once and for all. And verse 11 is saying, every priest standeth daily ministering oftentimes, the same sacrifice which can never take away sin. With all that they was doing, all the animals, they never was able to take away the sin consciousness of man. Yes. Glory to God. Verse 12 is our covenant.
Yes.
But this man,
yes.
Hallelujah, yes. After he has offered once sacrifice for sin forever.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Forever. So what are we wrestling with?
That's right.
Should it not sin consciousness? He has done it once and for all forever.
So sealed.
If you commit a sin, the Bible said confess.
Yes.
And the blood of Jesus. Glory to God. It's good enough. His blood. He didn't tell you to go out here and go get you a goat. Or get you some dove. But he just sprinkled the blood of Jesus over our conscience. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
So we thought we're going to lay aside the blood. I guess some banana, just something just came to me. I've been aiming to ask, and I forget to ask.
Yeah.
Pretty much every time I come to church, it's about the, maybe I've been, sure, have I been missing the communion or something?
Yeah.
If, huh? Oh, okay.
Yeah, we all have missed it.
Yeah, okay. I just wonder if I missed it. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The scripture says, do this in remembrance of who?
Yeah.
Yeah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But those sacrifices were never able to take away sin. But verse 12 says, but this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sin forever, sat down on the right hand of God. Glory to God. And basically he's saying, it was finished. It was complete. It is good enough. Hallelujah. And verse 13, from henceforth, expect until his end to be made his footstool. For by one offering he had perfected.